Easy!
Here also tell part of that long Navy story. The Mary Rose Trust is focused on the period of Henry VIII, while H.M.S. Warrior allows us to think about the 19th century story. On the other side of the water in Gosport is the National Museum. We have the Submarine Museum and the Museum of Naval Firepower. And at Eastleigh we have the Royal Marine Museum, soon to move to this site. Near Yeovil in Somerset is our magnificent Fleet Air Arm Museum. In Hartlepool, our frigate of 1817, H.M.S. Trincomalee. And that brings the Navy story to the northeast. And next week, H.M.S. Caroline opens in Belfast. She is the last survivor of the Battle of Jutland, of which we shall hear more later. Today's events start with H.M.S. Hood, the mighty Hood, sunk by Bismarck on this day 75 years ago. We meet here in an act of commemoration with members of the Hood Association to reflect on her loss. We are fortunate to have with us the team who, with the permission of the First Sea Lord, recovered Hood's bell, and Mr. Paul Allen, who so generously sponsored that recovery. Hood's bell is with us and will act as a focus of remembrance for HMS Hood and her gallant crew in the National Museum from this day forward. Very appropriate, as she was a Pompey ship. Our act of remembrance will finish at around noon, when we will process towards the entrance of the site, where the blockbuster exhibition at 36 hours, Jutland, 1916, The Battle That Won the War, is located. Her Royal Highness will open the exhibition. As I mentioned earlier, not all Jutland commemoration is focused here. HMS Caroline, an almost untouched World War ship, and one which fought at Jutland, will open on the centenary of the battle next week. On the same day, the 31st of May, a wreath will be laid at the battle site, and there will be a national act of commemoration in Kirkwall Cathedral. The battleships, of course, of the Grand Fleet were, after all, based at Scapa Flow in the Orkneys. But for those who want to see a ship of 1914, experience life on board her in all her myriad of aspects and witness something of the professionalism and dedication of the Royal Navy in the First World War, then a visit to Caroline must be on your bucket list. I should add that the strong and clear link between H.M.S. Hood and the Battle of Jutland will be explored. I would now like to call on the Reverend Martin Gough, Deputy.
Dear missions, off caps! Right, stand out, please! Stand, easy!
Waters, these have seen the works of the Lord and the wonders of his deep. At his word, the stormy wind arose and lifted up the waves of the sea. They were carried up to the heavens and down again to the deep. Their soul melted away in their peril. They reeled and staggered like a drunkard and were at their wits' end. Then they cried to the Lord in their trouble, and he brought them out in their distress. He made the storms be still, and the waves of the sea were calmed. Then were they glad because they were at rest, and he brought them to the haven they deserved.
Fantastic fine, isn't it?
So frustrating.
Side of it.